Still some brothers are praying. MashaAllah, yes. أهلا وسهلا. تفضل. احنا من الذين سمعنا مما سمعنا الليلة وإلا مثلا الحمد لله رب العالمين آية الرحمن الرحيم آية some ayats that we heard tonight from the Imam may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his heart his voice the Mawlana with due respect he is exception he can get all the ayats I know that from A to Z as they call it I want the brothers mashallah who are behind like myself and listening just one ayah one verse mashallah I we make 10 وعباد الرحمن طيب ها اني مور فكبكبوا فيها طيب ها طيب يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون الا من اتى الله بقلب سليم ها هو اجريز وذ مي يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون الا من اتى الله بقلب سليم هون از ذا مينينج فيرست ذا مينينج ذات داي لا ينفع مال واتس مال Even you say it in Urdu, mal, wealth, money, ولا بنون, children, إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Let's concentrate on the قلب سليم. What is قلب سليم? سليم, huh? Sound. Sound, heart. And what else? Has no holes. Nothing inside it. From a spiritual point of it, see, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Khali, salim, pure, sincere. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give that heart. Ameen, ya Rabbi, to us. That day that Ibrahim alayhi salam made dua and the ayahs before, wa la tukhzini yawma yub'athun. Oh Allah, do not let me to be any in any disgrace, any low position. يوم يبعثون, when they will be resurrected. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. In dunya, generally speaking, people are running after what? After wealth. And showing off, I got so and so. In that day, nothing of these two will benefit anybody. What is the benefit that will be with us? That قلب سليم. قلب سليم, قلب فيه التوحيد. قلب has the توحيد. قلب has nothing, as we talk about this last night, ألا يكون في القلب إلا الرب. Nothing to be in the heart but the رب الله سبحانه وتعالى جل جلاله. How can I do this? How can you do that? The ulama, the mashayikh of tazkiyah, of the tasawwuf sunni, of the self-purification, of the tazkiyah, as Imam Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah and his tasawwuf, ilm al-tasawwuf, wa amrad al-qulub, and so on and so on. They are mentioning few. We may put them in four. Make it easy. I'm practicing before teaching. Alhamdulillah, I've been teaching. Al-Lennik, of course. Introduction to At-Tazkiyah. Madkhal ila At-Tazkiyah. Very, very needed science. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to accept it and learn it the proper way. The first, you need someone who is with ilm in this field, in this art, art of qulub. It is an art, it's fun. As فن القراءات, فن التجويد, فن التفسير, فن الحديث. It is also an art, is also a field. We need it. And we lack in a lot. Either people who do not recognize it, or people who go too far, maybe too out of it even. And you know what I mean. But the i'tidal tazkiyah is there. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته. It's number one. تلاوة الآيات, that's دعوة. دعوة, reminding them. يتلو عليهم آياته. ويزكيهم, that's dial of قلوب. That's to get the outcome of that is a قلب سليم. sound heart. Heart has nothing but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fear, except the natural fear, that you fear the heat, you fear the too cold, you fear the chilly, but I don't, alhamdulillah. But some Arabs, they do, yeah. And mahabbat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart, that's all about the heart. So the first you need someone who knows that, and he is a murabbi. What is the wazifa? ما وظيفة المربي أن يعرفني ربي. I say it again. ما وظيفة المربي? What's the job of the murabbi? يعرفني ربي. Is to let me to recognize more my رب. That's his job. So the first is المربي. الشيخ العالم. And we look at all the ulama, they had somebody. We call it in our counseling field. It's one of my fields, alhamdulillah, counseling and psychology, called mentor. You know the mentor? And everyone got mentor, even when they are the president and prime minister, and they got a mentor. So you need a murshid. The second is sahib, sadiq, sadiq min al-sidq, sadaqa. He's saying the truth. He's telling you, bro, you move a lot in your salat. Bro, you are late. Bro, you this. And sister, says, MashaAllah. Make sure about the eyebrows. Make sure about that. Yes. Something like that. You have someone who is open with you. And if you don't find that, it is a disaster. If you don't have someone to tell you off, in the day of Qiyamah, wallahi, we regret it a lot. So the one, as Umar radiallahu anhu used to say, marhaban biman ahda ilayya ayyubi. Marhaban, welcome, welcome, ahlan wa sahlan. The one who gifted me, ahda, hadiyya, gifted me my faults. How many of us we have this? May Allah help us. You come to me and say, Sheikh, your thobe is a bit long. I say, what? Go and read Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he said, while he used to do this, and I'll start to give an argument with you. Amir al-Mu'min Umar, Khalifa of his time. Khalifa, he said, Marhaba. You give to me my faults. You are my mirror. Al-Mu'minu mir'atu akhi. So someone comes to you, even in a wrong way. You think, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent someone here so I can learn something, even if being disgraced in front of people. Wallahi la fadihatu dunya ahwan min fadihati al-akhirah. The Imam used to do it, many of them. Disgracing in this dunya is nothing compared to the disgracing of akhirah. So alhamdulillah, at least someone here is good. You man, he appointed you doing this. He said, I'm really sorry, astaghfirullah, please forgive me. You make dua for me. So number one is the sheikh, is the murshid, is the alim. Number two, sincere friend, that you and him make a contract. Please, tell me. Is it beard? Is it fashionable beard? Is it what do you think, my brother? I said, man, you can tell. I don't have to speak. Right. And the third, people speaking good about you, so you learn. Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, our Imam, our Habib, and our head. I'm not Hanafi, yes, but he's my Sheikh. And alhamdulillah, I'm qualified to teach Hanafi. In Egypt, where is the Sheikh? We got to learn one or two madhabs, maybe four madhabs, and then from our mashaykh, whatever madhab you, because we have the four schools to teach in Al-Azhar, alhamdulillah. Right, Imam Abu Hanifa heard someone is saying, هذا Abu Hanifa يصلي الفجر بوضوء العشاء. That's Abu Hanifa, he prays al-fajr with the same wudu of Aisha. So nearly 40 years after that, he said, I felt ashamed of Allah, people thinking of me that good, and I don't have to do it. I will do it. That's because of someone who spoke about it. And then the fourth, and we conclude with that, inshallah, before 1 o'clock. Allah give you barakah, Muhammad Ishaq. When you come to Manchester, you will see how I put you on the spot. He's my dear son in Islam for nearly 20 years or more. Alhamdulillah. Yeah, I used to drive on those days. There was no ban on having the phone and speak. He used to recite the Quran for me, and I'm driving. I said, Yabni, I'm driving Manchester to Leeds in the motorway. He said, but this is my slot, isn't it? My slot to recite for you. I said, MashaAllah. ما شاء الله. Listen to his Quran. تقبل الله منه ومنه. أمين يا رب العالمين. So the fourth is some talking about you in a bad way. So one of two things you do with that. In a bad way. First, if I have this bad habit, if I have these things, then I say, Ya Allah, help me. Ya Allah, help me. Save me from these bad habits. They say, you're moving a lot in your salat. You go out. Don't you know that smoking is haram, man? Even Al-Azhar, they get the fatwa, it's haram. Ha, ra, alif, meem, haram. Not haram, haram. Wallah, and some of them, Shaykh, can you give us fatwa of that? I can stamp it for you. It is haram. Because it is. Even the kuffar, they know, it is bad. And anything, ويحرم عليهم الخبائث. It is khabith. Yes, many of us, may Allah guide all of us, they have this habit. So they go, oh, this man, he got beard, he got this man in Musalli, and he go this out. Well, even his wife, just because she get used to that, she won't ask for divorce. Stuff. Yeah, some they say, look at your finger, man. Look at your teeth. Don't you feel ashamed of yourself? What is this? Where? And some of our mashaykh in Egypt, they say, where can you smoke? Can you smoke in the masjid? No. Where can you smoke? In the toilet. I say, can't you understand, man? You go to Baytul Khala to smoke, and you don't know the hukm, the rule of smoking. You smoke in Baytul Khala, in the filth there. If good, you will not take it inside. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. So some people are speaking about that person in a bad way, me and you. So you say, if it is true, Ya Allah, help me, save me. Is you, Ya Allah. And two rakats, and be sincere. Years ago, in my young age, my ustaz, my sheikh, rahmatullah, he came to know that I had this. I've tried it, any of young age. So don't think, I don't know what smoking. Those age. And I said, don't leave it for your health. I said, it's bad for my health. He said, don't make intention for that. That is wrong intention. He said, Allahumma give him rahmat wa maghfirat. He passed away in one of the nights in the 10 Ashara in the Masjid al-Haram in I'tikaf, and he was buried, Sheikh Mamduh ibn Sayyid Hassan from Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, rahmatullah alayhi, from the Sunni. My Sheikh, my Ustaz, Allah give rahmat wa maghfirat, and all my a'mal, all good a'mal in his kitab, in his book, Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. He was of those of do this standard, mashallah, rahmatullah alayhi. So this is bad intention, not for your health. I said, and money was, I said, not for this. I said, just to please Allah and two rakats and cry to him, he will help you. I said, I stop for a while, I return. I said, for this, you come back and speak to me. And alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, I just put in my heart, Ya Allah, let me have hate, take this out of my heart. No desire for it, Ya Allah, please. The following morning, I couldn't smell it. Stop it. This is all recorded, subhanAllah. And I do it with some of my students. I said it like that. Nearly a couple of months later, I found in my coat 4 cigarettes. I said, subhanAllah. Still in my coat on this. I said, Bismillah. Fi zibala, in the bin. And I say this with men. And my Sheikh, rahmatullah, used to do the same jawla. And so I seen it in the marketplace in Cairo. Catch people, got discouraged. And this himmat, he catch people and say, Ibni, speak to him 2-3 minutes. And he's getting either bucket like this and put it under his feet. He says, subhanAllah. And he used to say, at least in your salat, take the cigarette packet out and put it there, outside, or the shurak there. Because it's filth. Get it out. SubhanAllah. So we learn. It seems I'm talking a lot about smoking. So a sheikh, a murabbi, to get you to recognize Rabbi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A sincere friend. Third, people talking good about you. Say, Ya Allah, please, let me have this. And people talking bad about you. So you learn. One, if you have it, asking Allah to help. And if you don't, say, Ya Allah, save me from having what they think bad of me, and forgive them. And what else you do, as I learned from my sheikh, and I do it, may Allah accept it, and Ya Allah make it sincere to you, They said they talking about you, Sheikh, that you just somebody you don't know. I said, Ibni, this is just brand new. Go to this person and don't tell him who gifted him. This is for him. The one speaking bad about me. This is what I learned. Take this to him. Don't tell him this from who. But few days later, say, this is from Awadallah. The one I heard you speaking in a bad way about him. We're sweating, of course. So this is the way. He's gifting you some of his hasanat. Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i, Imam al-Shafi'i, rahmatullahi, said, if I am to speak in a bad way about somebody, I will speak about my parents in a bad way. They say, why you speak about your parents? They don't have that, they don't have that, they were poor, they don't have money, they don't have anything. In a bad way, the people don't like it. They say, they are the people who are deserved to take some of my hasanat. Nobody else. If I speak bad about somebody, speak about my own parents. But you don't, of course. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jalla Jalalu, to grant myself and yourself qalban salim. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Jazakumullah khairan for great hospitality. And I request you to make intention, because we came mainly for Mastura Jama'at. Alhamdulillah, my dear wife is with me. And also some brothers, mashallah, their wives, their sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it. So the deen can come in a practical way in people's life. Make intention, inshallah. Those who have not been in Masturat Da'wah, say, inshallah, I will go. Raise your hand so I can jazakum al-khair, and I complete. If you don't raise your hand, I keep standing so much. Raise your hand, say, inshallah, I will go. We'll go Masturat. Everyone, inshallah, ready? What does mean Masturat? To go you and some of your mahram, your wife, your mother, your sister, fi sabilillah. Spend time as we have done here in your masjid, inshallah. Jazakumullah ahsan al-jaza. May Allah bless your children, your family, your members, and may Allah accept this masjid, Isa ibn Maryam, to be means of rahman. May Allah accept everyone who's making dua, who's helping, who's giving a pound, who's giving less or more, who's cleaning the masjid, who's doing whatsoever khidmah for this masjid. May Allah elevate their stature, accept their a'mal, mikul a'mal sincere, amin, ya Rabbil Alameen. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salaman al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You can take it back now, inshallah.